Mega World's Real Estate Investment Trust eyeing to diversify its portfolio beyond just office assets. It confirmed comments by its president and CEO Kevin Tan that MREIT could explore retail assets this year. Tan says this would allow MREIT to have a balanced portfolio that would prove to be resilient in the market. Next, to Alternergy, which secured regulatory approval to wipe out a $42 million deficit. This came as the renewable energy firm's directors approved a quasi-reorganization of the company. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. targeting 3 million new jobs for Filipinos before the end of his term. The chief executive made that statement as he led this year's National Employment Summit. The jobs target is encompassed in the administration's 10-year roadmap that will serve as a guide to achieving the country's labor goals.
The arrival of the digital economy, the expansion of the digital space, the soon, already, actually is already here, we don't just quite realize it, but the increasing involvement of AI requires the technical knowledge and the technical training and experience for us to be able to participate. And that is the job of government. We have exciting times that lie ahead. We have we look forward to the new jobs, the new sectors, the new opportunities that are waiting for us and for the Philippines.
President Marcos admits the Philippines needs to do more in the face of China's growing aggression in disputed waters. He notes the country has already filed over 100 protests against Beijing. The president also says while the latest incident in Ayungin Shoal cannot be considered an armed attack, it was still a deliberate and illegal action by Chinese forces.
We have over 100 already protests. We have already made the similar number of demarches. So we have to do more than just that. Kasi papatawag natin yung ambassador, sasabihin natin itong posisyon namin, hindi namin gusto yung nangyari, and that's it. But we have to do more than that, so we are. So we're doing more than just that. It's not armed. Mm-hmm. Walang pumutok. Hindi tayo tinutukan ng baril.
Sorry,
but it was a deliberate action to stop our people. In the process of that, kinuhanan tayo, they boarded a Philippine vessel and took the equipment from that Philippine vessel. So, although there were no arms involved, nonetheless, it is still a deliberate action, and it is essentially an illegal action that was taken by the Chinese forces.
Meanwhile, President Marcos set to name the country's next education chief this week. He says it's an important position that can't be left vacant for so long. Marcos also says until now, Vice President Sara Duterte has not given him a reason for her resignation as Education Secretary. As for the Duterte's surprising announcement, they will seek 3 Senate seats in next year's midterm polls. This is what the President had to say.
It's a free country. They're allowed to do whatever it is they want. I have no reaction to it. Besides, it's still early. We really won't know any of these things. We're talking about 2028. Ang dami pang mangyayari between now and 2028. And the only real situation will become clear in October, sa filing.